Hello everyone! Today we are going to learn about the futures contract. A futures contract is very similar to a forward contract and is also an agreement to buy or sell a physical or financial asset at a later date for a predetermined price. However, unlike forward contracts, future contracts are traded on an exchange and are regulated. The exchange is responsible for setting the specifications of each contract, that is, the quality, quantity, the settlement date or physical delivery date and location. Most of the contracts are cash settled, but for commodity futures, traders can opt for physical settlement. These contract specifications are same for all traders, and these contracts cannot be customized as per individual preferences. Price is the only variable that is determined by the market forces of demand and supply. Standardization enhances liquidity, and this enables the buyer and seller to easily transfer their contract obligation to another party by the way of a trade. The traders can exit or close out their positions if the price movement is favorable. For example, if the price increases, the long may want to book profits and exit the contract. He can sell the contract to someone else through the stock exchange. If the price decreases, the short can book profits and exit the contract by selling it to someone else. Thus, the contracts need not be held till expiry, and positions can be closed prior to expiry or settlement date. As the clearing house is the counterparty for each trade, the default risk is eliminated, and the buyer and seller remain anonymous to each other. We have already covered the features of exchange-traded contracts in our previous video, OTC versus exchange-traded contracts. Mark-to-market is another distinguishing feature of futures market compared to forwards. It is the process by which daily profits and losses of the futures position is calculated and settled. In the OTC markets, the gains or losses are settled on the expiry date. But in exchange-traded contracts, the gains or losses are settled on a daily basis using the closing prices. You still have your long position in the contract, and the contract is still open. Example, if you have taken a long position in the corn futures contract of $100 and the closing or settlement prices for the day is $102, then you have a positive value of $2 per bushel of corn. As one futures contract is for 500 bushels of corn, your profit for the day is 2 multiplied by 500, which is equal to $1,000. If the closing prices on the next day is $106, then compared to the previous day's closing of $102, you now have a gain of $4 per bushels of corn. Today's profit is 4 multiplied by 500 bushels, which is equal to $2,000. If the long position is gaining $1,000 and $2,000, then the short position is losing $1,000 and $2,000 respectively. The closing price is the same for all traders and all the futures contracts. The losers pay the winners every day, and the losses are not carried forward. This daily settlement of profit and loss is called as mark-to-market, and the amount is automatically adjusted to the margin account, which we will learn next. Another important characteristic of the futures contract is the margin requirement. Futures margin is the amount of money that both long and short must deposit as a collateral with their respective brokers when they enter into a futures position. It is not a down payment, but a kind of security towards your contractual obligation. Margin is calculated as a certain percentage of the contract's notional value. Suppose one futures contract on 500 bushels of corn is currently priced at $100 and the margin required is 10% of the contract's notional value. The notional value is 500 bushels multiplied by $100, which is equal to $50,000, and both the buyer and seller of the futures contract need to deposit 10% of $50,000, that is $5,000, with their respective brokers. This 10% margin is known as the initial margin. The clearing house sets the initial margin requirement, but the broker can collect additional funds. By depositing only a small percentage of value, that is $5,000, the traders are able to get an exposure on the entire contract that is worth $50,000. Thus, futures are highly leveraged instruments and are risky. The daily settlement of profit and loss that we learned before will be adjusted to this margin account. This is how the margin account of both long and short futures trader will look at the end of two settlement days. The margin account of both the long and short fluctuates on a daily basis. The maintenance margin is the minimum amount that must be kept in the margin account. If the value of margin account falls below this maintenance margin, then the trader must deposit additional funds and bring the account back to the levels of initial margin. Example: if the maintenance margin is set at $2,500, we see that the short has only $2,000 in his margin account at the end of day 2. The short will receive a margin call from his broker or clearing house, and he will have to deposit additional funds of $3,000 to bring his account back to the level of initial margin of $5,000. This $3,000 is called as the variation margin. If the trader does not deposit these additional funds after receiving the margin call, the broker will automatically close or liquidate the position in order to prevent additional losses. By ensuring daily settlement of profits and losses, the clearing house is able to ensure that each party fulfills his obligation and no party faces the risk of default. If the daily price volatility increases, the margin requirements will also increase, and vice versa. When the futures position is closed, the remaining margin money after trade settlement can be returned to the account holder. Forward contracts are settled only on the expiry, but future contracts are settled on a daily basis. At the end of each day, the trader's gain or loss is added to or subtracted from the margin account, bringing the value of the contract back to zero. Here is what we can conclude. Initial margin is what both the long and short must deposit with their brokers in order to enter into a futures position. Mark-to-market is the daily settlement of profit and loss that is adjusted to the margin account. Maintenance margin is the minimum balance that must always be kept in the margin account. If the value of the account falls below the maintenance margin, the trader will receive a margin call. Variation margin is the additional amount that must be deposited by the trader in order to bring the margin account back to the levels of initial margin. Otherwise, his position will be liquidated or closed automatically. The futures contract may trade at a premium or discount before the expiry date. But upon expiry, the futures price will converge with the spot market price of the underlying. The closing price of the spot market will be equal to the closing prices of the futures contract expiring on that date. If the traders do not square off their positions before or on expiry date, the exchange will automatically square off their positions at the convergence price.